Deep down in us, we find what makes us function, what makes us human, our proteins. And now, we're seeing them like we've never seen them before. One of the largest organs in the human body is the skeletal muscle. Its main function is contraction, which results in us being able to move our bodies. The muscles are controlled by a finely tuned network of so-called alpha motor neurons. But in the case of amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS, the connections between the muscle fibers and the motor neurons fail. The Human Protein Atlas Project is mapping out all of the different proteins in the human body. And through the HPA Open Access website, researchers can study these proteins and see exactly where they are located. For example, the predominant cell type in skeletal muscle is the myocyte, which contains the proteins actin and myosin. And the type of myosin present in a muscle fiber determines if it's a fast fiber, used for running, for example, or a slow fiber, like that used for maintaining our posture. And this is important in ALS research because the two fiber types respond differently to the disease. And with the help of a light sheet microscope, the HPA researchers can now study the muscle proteins in 3D, creating micro-universes of the proteins in our bodies.
Being able to see through tissues and to visualize the proteins in them in 3D rather than 2D will make us understand organs and how they function in health as well as disease in a completely new way.
This new technique enables Eva Hedlund to further our understanding of ALS.
In red, you see the filamentous structures of the muscle fibers, and in blue, you see the fine network of innervation from alpha motor neurons onto these muscle fibers. The innervation, or this network, forms three major branches, sort of reminiscent of trees. In the middle one, you can clearly see the motor endplates visualized. These are part of the functional contact points, or synapses, between a muscle and a motor neuron. A signal is sent from the nervous system, which makes the muscle fiber contract.
But in the case of ALS, the motor neurons start to degenerate. And when the signal is lost, the muscle fibers atrophy, leading to weakness and paralysis.
Even when we know the genetic cause of ALS, we still don't understand why these motor neurons are particularly vulnerable, and we don't know why the synapses, these contact points between muscle and motor neuron, are so swiftly broken down. If we can visualize them at very high resolution, as you see in these movies, we can get a better understanding of how these synapses, these contact points, work in normal health, and also visualize disease processes that occur in ALS. And we think that such knowledge can really help us to maybe strengthen these synapses and prevent the breakdown in ALS.
When we explore the world in new ways, we discover new things about us, about life itself. And now we see our proteins like we've never seen them before.